Dear students of 11th class, I'm Sarwar Murshid Khan, Assistant Professor English, Rajbari Government College, Rajbari. Welcome to online class conducted by Rajbari Government College. In my previous two classes, I was discussing on the speech made by Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman on 7th March 1971. Now, today, I will take my last class with you on the 7th March speech of Bangabandhu. The 7th March speech of Bangabandhu was a speech given by Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, the founding father of Bangladesh, on 7th March 1971 to a gathering of over 2 million people. You know, it was delivered during a period of escalating tensions between East Pakistan and the powerful political and military establishment of West Pakistan. Dear students, Bangabandhu announced a civil disobedience movement in the province, calling for every house to turn into a fortress. The speech inspired the Bengali people to prepare for a war of independence. Amid widespread reports of armed mobilization by West Pakistan, the Bangladesh Liberation War began 18 days later when the Pakistan Army launched Operation Searchlight against Bengali civilians, intelligentsia, students, politicians, and armed personnel. Do you know about Operation Searchlight? The Pakistan rulers, the Pakistan armies tortured, attacked abruptly the people of East Pakistan on the black night of 25th March 1971. And this operation was named Operation Searchlight. In his historic address, in the historic address made by Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman declared, "Ebare Sangram, Amader Muktir Sangram. Ebare Sangram, Shadinotar Sangram. The struggle this time is for our emancipation. The struggle this time is for our independence." Bangabandhu made the clarion call to turn every home into a fortress of resistance against Pakistani army. Dear students, the Bengalis were very much tortured by the Pakistan. Bengalis reacted with unprecedented rage after the then Pakistani military ruler Yahya Khan postponed the National Assembly session scheduled for March 1, 1971. The Bengalis became astonished to observe the conspiracy made by Yahya Khan. Stunned by the treachery, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman immediately launched an unprecedented non-cooperation movement, dealing a crippling blow to the military rulers. Bangabandhu protested against this injustice, and so he launched an unprecedented non-cooperation movement, Asahajog Andolan, dealing a crippling blow to the military rulers. Dear students, on March 7, 1971, Bangabandhu gave a historic address at Sarwardi Udan, the then race course, which inspired the nation to fight for independence. And this speech inspired us to be united, to get prepared for the war of independence. we became brave, we became self-confident by the speech made by Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. The address reduced the government authorities in the then East Pakistan to useless showpieces, as everything ran according to Mujib's day-to-day edicts. Bangabandhu became the undisputed personality, and everything then was run by the order of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. Officially, Yahya Khan was the ruler of Pakistan, but East Pakistan was being run by the order made by Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. This continued until the military junta retaliated with crackdown and the accompanying brutalities against the unarmed Bengalis on the fateful midnight of March 25, 1971, and the rest is a history. The rest is a history, and we know this history. We know the history of the war of independence of Bangladesh. We know the history of Bangladesh. We know the contribution made by Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. We know the dedication of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman to the people, to the poor people, to the oppressed people, to the downtrodden people of Pakistan, as well as Bangladesh. The historic 7th March speech of Mujib has been included, you know, in the memory of the World International Register, a list of world's important documentary heritage maintained by UNESCO. As a result, the people all over the world will be able to understand, will able to see, will able to watch the speech made by Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, and they will be able to justify the contribution, justify the devotion of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman to the soil of Bengal, to the people of Bengal, especially to the oppressed people of Bangladesh. Dear students, let us go to the text. Let us go to the speech made by Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman now. To those in the armed forces, I have this to say: you are my brothers. Stay in your barracks and no one will bother you. But don't try again to aim our bullets at our chests. You can't suppress 70 million people forever. Since we have learned to sacrifice ourselves, no one can suppress us anymore. Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman requested the people, addressed the people to go to the barracks and be calm and quiet. But he is roaring that if any bullet is shot by the Pakistani army, then the people of East Pakistan, then the 70 million people of East Pakistan will not allow this. Bangabandhu is saying, since we have learned to sacrifice ourselves, no one can surpass us anymore. Bangabandhu is saying that you can't surpass 70 million people forever. Banglar 7 koti manushke dabaye rakhte parba na. We know, I cannot help remembering a famous speech, Shrinkhal sara proletariat er harabar kichu nei, joy koribar jonno royeche samagra jagat. We find a similarity with this speech, Since we have learned to sacrifice ourselves, no one can surpass us anymore. Bangabandhu is saying that we have nothing to lose. We have already been suppressed. We have already been oppressed. We have already been discriminated by the rulers. So we have nothing to lose. We have something to gain. And the Bengali will overcome. Soon, the Bengali will overcome one day. Baba Bangabandhu was of course a very optimistic people. He was always optimistic. He was always rebellious. We find his optimism is in his speech. And thereafter, the optimism of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman had been shifted to the 70 million people of Bangladesh. Please, let us read the text. And as for our martyrs and those who have been wounded, we in the Awami League will do everything we can to assist them and their loved ones. Bangabandhu is assuring help and cooperation to the dead people, to the family of the dead people and the wounded people. And this will be done, this will be conducted by the leadership of the Awami League. And Bangabandhu, you know, was the undisputed leader of Awami League. If you have the means, please give what little you can to our relief committee. He is requesting the people of East Pakistan to contribute to the relief committee met by the political party Awami League, and the Awami League leaded by Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman was trying to render help and cooperation to the family of the dead people and the wounded people. To owners of factories whose workers had participated in the general strike the last 7 days, I have this to say: make sure that they are paid wages for those days. He is requesting to the owner of the mills and factories to pay the wages of the employees who participated the movement last 7 days. To government employees, I have this to tell: you all will have to listen to my directives. He is addressing the government employees to obey his directions. Till our country is liberated, taxes and custom duties won't be collected. He is ordering not to collect tax and custom duties, because these taxes and these custom duties were used to buy arms, and these arms were being used to the people of East Pakistan. No one will pay them either. He is forbidding the people of East Pakistan not to pay any tax and custom duties for the time being. Remember, Munir Akbar, the enemy is amidst us to create chaos and confusion, to create anarchy and to loot. Bangabandhu understood that the Pakistan rulers were trying to make chaos and confusion among the people of East Pakistan, among the leaders of the East Pakistan. They were making conspiracy, they were creating anarchy, and they were looting. In our Bengal, Hindus and Muslims, Bengalis and non-Bengalis are all brothers. I have already told you that Bangabandhu was heart and heart a secular person. There was no difference There was no difference among Hindus, Muslims, Christians, Bengalis, non-Bengalis, and to Bangabandhu. And he is addressing all by saying, brothers. Who are the brothers? The Hindus are the brothers, the Muslim, the Hindus are the brothers, the Muslims are the brothers, the Bengalis are the brothers, the non-Bengalis were the brothers of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. He was a large-hearted person. He was a large-hearted person. He cherished the responsibility to Bengali. He cherished the responsibility to Bengali in his heart. Bangabandhu is saying, we are responsible for their safety. Let us not taint ourselves in any way. He is forbidding us to commit any crime, to show any hostile attitude to Hindus, to non-Bengalis, Christians. He is singing the song of brotherhood. Bangabandhu is singing the song of brotherhood. Remember, those of you who work for radio and television, if people running the radio station aren't ready to listen to us, no Bengalis will report for work there. Bangabandhu is addressing to the worker of the radio and television. If the Pakistani government didn't pay any attention to us, to the people of East Pakistan, then you would not listen to them. And you would not report, if it not report work there, banks will be open for 2 hours every day so that people can collect their salaries. I have also told you that Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman was a visionary leader. He is saying to the employees of the banks that they would go to bank, they would open the bank for 2 hours so that the people could collect their salaries. But we would not allow even a single paisa to be transferred from East Pakistan to West Pakistan. Bangabandhu is warning that no single paisa to be transferred from East Pakistan to West Pakistan. I have already told you that the money collected from the people of East Pakistan was being used to kill the people of East Pakistan. It was very pathetic that the monies sent by us was then used to suppress us. If we have to transmit news abroad, you will see to that. But if any attempt is made to exterminate our people, all Bengalis must take appropriate actions. He was a very reasonable person, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. He didn't want any chaos and confusion. But if any attempt was made to exterminate our people, all Bengalis must take appropriate action against this Pakistani ruler. Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman is saying, form revolutionary committee under the leadership of Awami League in every village, every community. Bangabandhu is ordering to create revolutionary committee under the leadership of Awami League in every village and every community. Be prepared to act with whatever you have in your possession. Bangabandhu understood that the Pakistan ruler, would attack us soon. And he is addressing us, he is requesting us to be prepared to act with whatever you have in your possession. তোমাদের যা 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 কিছু আছে তাই নিয়ে প্রস্তুত থাকো. Remember, মনে রাখবা, since we have already had to shed blood, we will have to shed lot more of it by the grace of God, whoever we will be able to liberate the people of this land. রক্ত যখন দিয়েছি রক্ত আরো দিব. বঙ্গবন্ধু is saying that রক্ত যখন আমরা দিয়েছি রক্ত আরো দিব, তবু আমাদেরকে দাবায় রাখতে পারবে না, আমাদেরকে পরাধীনতার শৃঙ্খলে রাখতে পারবে না. উই শ্যাল ওভারকাম ওয়ান ডে. বঙ্গবন্ধু ইজ রোয়ারিং, দ্য স্ট্রাগল দিস টাইম ইজ এ স্ট্রাগল ফর ফ্রিডম. এবারের সংগ্রাম স্বাধীনতার সংগ্রাম. দ্য স্ট্রাগল ইজ টাইম ইজ এ স্ট্রাগল ফর ইমানসিপেশন. এবারের সংগ্রাম মুক্তির সংগ্রাম. And this is the declaration of the war of independence. And this is the declaration of the war of independence. You know, there is controversy. There is controversy. There is a controversy in our country. But you must be adamant. You must be determined that Bangabandhu declared the declared the war of Bangabandhu declared the declaration of the war of independence. No person except Bangabandhu is or was engaged in this issue. It's propaganda made by some people of Bangladesh. Bangabandhu declared the war of independence. The struggle this time is a struggle for freedom. The struggle this time is a struggle for emancipation. Ebare sangram swadhinotar sangram, ebare sangram muktir sangram. Live long Bangladesh, joy Bangla. Bangla Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman ended his speech by saying, joy Bangla, live long Bangladesh. It's a matter of great regret that Bangabandhu was unseen. Bangabandhu was unwatched for a long time. The democracy, the humanity of Bangladesh were guided by the puts of armed forces of Bangladesh. But now the democracy has been restored in Bangladesh. It's a matter of pleasure that Sheikh Hasina, the Prime Minister of Bangladesh, is the daughter of undisputed leader Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, the best son of the soil. Bangladesh is being run by the leadership of Sheikh Hasina. The democracy has been restored. Our government, the government led by Sheikh Hasina, is trying to cherish the dream of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. The government is trying to make the dream of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman true. And you know, huge development activities are being run under this government. And Bangladesh has already been introduced as the country of democracy, as the country of bravery against national calamities. Thank you very much. Bangabandhu was our leader. Bangabandhu is our leader, and Bangabandhu will be the leader of Bangladesh forever. Thank you very much.
Hello.